The hugs and smiles say it all. U.S. troops reunited with the stray dogs they found in Afghanistan. Petty Officer Zachary Henning was deployed for a year, but it wasn't a true homecoming until Gus made it.
I've been home for 2 months and I've been waiting for him ever since. He helped me survive out there, and now I'm going to give him a home and allow him to survive now.
Specialist Sheila Schaefer says these stray dogs give nothing but love, and that's how they're saving lives.
It's not always saving from an IED or a bomb. It's a lot of times with soldiers, we have a lot that commit suicide from depression. It's saving our spirits too. You know, it doesn't have to be a physical save. It's a spiritual save.
Sergeant Penn Farthing is a former British Marine and adopted his dog, Nalzad, while serving in Afghanistan. He says the Taliban banned people from having dogs as pets.
If it's a male dog, it may be used for dog fights. If not, it's just discarded on the street and it may then just fight for scraps.
So he started the animal rescue group called Nalzad that tries to save animals in Afghanistan and reunite them with servicemen and women throughout the world when the troops return home. Sergeant Adam Rinneker says his dog Freedom will now live a life of freedom.
I do a lot of hunting and we live on a couple farms, so sure I'll be doing a lot of running, and I have another dog that she'll be running around with playing with.
Lieutenant Colonel Joseph Crescito couldn't wait to introduce us to his newest family members.
And this is Hesco. And he's a little puppy, about 4 to 5 months old. And this is Nikita, and she's a full-grown, looks like a husky Bernard mix.
And after knowing only a life of war, they're now headed home. At Kennedy Airport, Cindy Hsu, CBS 2 News.